In today's video, I wanted to talk about the Dehancer Pro version 4, which is available now for Windows as well as macOS, and walk you through the changes that they made to two specific effects, the halation and bloom effects. If you want to know more about this plugin, I've done two longer videos that walk through the entire plugin, and I'll link those in the description if you want to go check those out. But in today's video, I wanted to focus on the halation and bloom. They've changed the controls for those, giving you more ability to really fine tune those and dial them in how you want. But the controls can be a little bit confusing, so I wanted to walk you through how they work and exactly what's going on with them. I do have a bit of an ulterior motive in that I do have a promo code, which you can see here. If you use my promo code, you can get 10% off the plugin or any of the individual effects that they sell, and I'll get a 10% commission. So let's go ahead and just jump into the bloom and halation effects. Starting with bloom, what this is doing is actually adding a bloom to any really bright area in your image. So anything that's actually reflecting light can be a source of bloom. So once you understand that, you can get a better grasp of how this is working. So I'm gonna turn on the mask mode. Well, let's enable bloom, turn on mask mode, and just skip to the source limiter. What this does is limit what is actually generating bloom in your image. And I find that if you go all the way to the right, what you're getting is something that's more akin to what you might expect from something like a diffusion filter, where really the highlights are what's blooming or light sources. But if you go the other way, really anything that's reflecting light can be a source of bloom. And the further left you go, the more individual bright things can generate bloom. And this also works in tandem with the detail slider. Details is saying that all the way to the right, regardless of size, pretty much anything that's reflecting a lot of bright light can generate bloom. If you go to the left, only increasingly larger areas of brightness will generate bloom. So all the way to the left means only the biggest things that are generating a bright white or a bright source will generate bloom. Working back from those two, highlights all the way to the left basically means only the very brightest thing in the frame is going to generate bloom. And then the more you go to the right, you can have less and less bright things generate bloom. So those are the big ones. Once you figure out those three things, you're pretty much well on your way to understanding the rest of it. Diffusion is what you would think. The more you go to the right, the more diffused the bloom effect becomes. The more to the left you go, the more hard and linear the effect is. Amplify is just the overall strength, brightness of the bloom. I'm gonna skip to another clip to show you the next couple things here. Save lights. When you're adding bloom to a light source or any bright part of your image, you have the potential of increasing its exposure to the point where it could clip. Save lights prevents that from happening. So all the way to the right means that you will prevent something that's clipping. You will prevent something from clipping by adding the bloom effect. If it's already clipped prior to bloom, it's not going to bring it back. So you can see that in this example, if I just turn the bloom off, in this part here, we essentially don't have any detail, but all around this light source, we do have areas of information. And turn the bloom back on, and you can see we're still retaining everything that was already there, but now we have some bloom added to it. If you decrease the save lights, it will, having increased the brightness of that part by adding the bloom, you're also losing, you're increasing the amount of that area that has clipped. So if you want to save all that information, then increase the save lights to 100% or however much you need. If you want to lose that information for some reason, going to the left will allow everything to clip. Saturation, from what I can tell, just means that if you have whatever color the light source is or the bright source is, it will retain that color if saturation is all the way to the right. And if you go to the left, the blooming effect will start to become white. You can see that on the fire here as well. The blooming is white now. Whereas if we go back to the right, the bloom will retain the color of the original source. Lastly, you just have an overall impact slider, which works just like any impact slider that you might be familiar with any other LUT you might be working with. Now let's go ahead and move on to the halation effect. What halation is, I'm not gonna talk about how it happens, but what it is you get usually a red outline in high contrast areas of your shot. So when I enable this, and let me zoom in. So you see we have a high contrast area, the really dark part butting up against a really white spot, or a really bright spot, I should say. This is where you will see halation the most. And when I turn it up, that's what you get. So that's what halation is. Usually it's red, but you have the ability to change the hue. Here you can go towards orange, and then all the way to the right becomes yellow. So I'm gonna turn the mask mode on so we can really see what's going on. The two controls that you have to wrap your brain around in order to understand how this works are the first two, the source limiter and the background gain. So the source limiter, think the source being the actual bright spot. This is the part that is generating the halation. So when it's all the way to the left in its default state, bright spots at up to a certain threshold will generate halation. When you go to the right, basically only the brightest and brightest and brightest spots in the image will continue to generate halation, to the point now where, turn this global down. If we zoom in, there's only a few areas left that are still generating any halation. Whereas if we go back to the left, pretty much every bright spot at a certain threshold is generating some halation. So that's what the source limiter means. Now, background gain means that where the halation is going to appear. So the bright parts are what's generating the halation, but the dark areas on that edge are where the halation appears. So background gain means that if we turn to the left, less and less halation is actually going to appear along those high contrast edges, and only like the really super high contrast edges are going to retain the halation. So those are the two big ones in controlling where and how much the halation actually appears in your image. And the rest of it is just sort of refining the effect. Smoothness is basically just what it says. It's a very subtle effect, and you can only really see it if you zoom in. So if we increase smoothness, you just start getting a little bit more, it's almost like a saturation when you increase the smoothness. It's increasing the density and the amount of the halation. Whereas when you go to the left, it becomes a little bit more scattered, I guess, is a way to describe it. But without zooming in and without the mask mode, it's really hard to see that difference. So this is just a very subtle one that you can just sort of fine tune to your liking. Local diffusion means that along those high contrast edges, you're adding or subtracting the amount of diffusion. So going to the right, you're really increasing the diffuseness, the diffusion of the halation. Going all the way to the left really drops it down to just a very, very defined edge, to the point where you can't even see it. So there you go. Versus that. Global diffusion is another new slider in version 4. So regardless of the edges, this is allowing you to globally contaminate your whole image with the halation artifact. Instead of just being localized to high contrast edges, now you're getting the tint, the redness, to pollute the entire image. So it's like adding a red tint to your image, and you can see that, you know, looking at the skin tones, looking at the walls. The global diffusion will basically like warm up the image in a way. Amplify is again same as the bloom, just increasing and decreasing the intensity of the overall effect. Hue, I've already showed you, changes the effect from pure red to orange to yellow. Blue comp is something that I can't really explain too well. Apparently it's emulating what happens when you have a blue cast to your image, whether it's from a blue light source or a blue white balance or something. It apparently affected the way that halation would appear. So they're trying to emulate that, but in this image, there's not really a strong blue cast. So what ends up happening with this blue comp is that it basically makes the image a lot warmer, adds a lot more yellow into it when you slide that over to 100 versus its neutral state, which retains the original color cast of the image. So that's what the blue comp does. I don't have a good example of how it's supposed to interact with an image, but you can see it's just another thing that you can adjust according to your own taste or the effect that you want to achieve. So that's it. I just wanted to cover the changes that Dehancer have made to the bloom and halation effects and just explain how these are working. They can be a little bit confusing. So hopefully that helps you. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, obviously leave them in the comments. Thank you for watching this video. I really appreciate it. Maybe check out whatever it is YouTube is recommending you watch. Otherwise, I just hope you have a good day, and maybe I'll see you again. Goodbye.